Good morning, everyone. This morning, I'm very happy. This morning, I'm very, very excited. And at the same time, I am very, very angry. Very, very sad. And because I'm very angry, I will be very subtle in my choice of words. Because if I say it the way it is in my heart right now, a lot of people will be hurt by my choice of words. So I will have to take it one step at a time. I am happy because a lot of slaves are tired of their chains. They've committed their chains. They are tired of slavery. We have a lot of people, thousands of people, open confession ongoing. They are tired of being saboteurs. They are tired of sabotaging what we are doing. And they are talking, opening their mouths. Hannah says, "No, no." They said the wicked shall never go unpunished. Once you are sabotaging our struggle, you will never go unpunished. And it's only a matter of time. And that is what is ongoing. That's why I'm so happy and excited this morning. And I am angry, like I said, because of the sea finish ongoing in Nigeria. Because of the sea finish, because we accepted to be one Nigeria. Because I agree to this one Nigerian disease. Because I agree to this one Nigeria infection, Hausa people are now seeing us finish. Are you hearing me? Few days ago, if not few weeks, Yorubas and Hausas, we are having little misunderstanding. This misunderstanding led to fighting. The fighting led to people being killed. Both Hausas and Yorubas were killed in the fight. Now, Hausas, out of the anger that their trailers were burnt, their onions trailers and their tomato trailers were burned and their businesses were shut down because of the fight. They now said they will have to block every means onions and tomato will get to us in the east and get to you, Yorubas, in the west. That federal government of Nigeria, there must be compensation, not federal government, though, that the Yorubas, that they must get their compensation for the people, the onions dealers that were killed. Hausa people said that they must be compensated for the 14 Hausa onions dealers that were killed. I hope the figures are correct. That there must be compensation. If not, they will stab all of you with onions and tomatoes and cucumber, carrots, cabbage. Are you hearing me? I hope you are understanding where I'm coming from. Now, help me tell that malam. I want you to talk to any malam around you. You said that your people were killed. And because of that, there must be compensation. Let me take you back to memory lane, malam. If you say you need compensation for your 14 people that were killed, you have to not pity us in Igbo. That they have been killing like where they are killing cockroach. You have to pity Igbo people. That they have been killing like where they are killing mosquito. Ah! At every slightest provocation. Ah, any little thing, ah, they will kill Igbo people. You have to pity us then. I want to take you back to memory lane, malam. You said they killed your people in the west. In 1991 riot in the Kano State, in Kano State, how many Igbo people were killed? Thousands of Igbo people were killed. Thousands of businesses were shut down in Kano State in 91. Was there compensation made? Did anybody compensate Igbo people for the people that were massacred in 91? Yorubas were killed in 91 riots. Igbos were massacred. Akwa Ibom, Calabar, Edo State. A lot of people were killed in 91 Kano State riots. Were we compensated? How many people got compensation? None. I have to be very honest. None were compensated. Igbo people flew away from the north to the east. Some people started from square one. Let me take you back to memory lane again. In the 60s, 1967, civil war, the genocide that was committed by Nigerian government. More than 3.5 million Biafrans were killed. Was there compensation? Are we even remembered? At least, even if you don't want to give a physical compensation or cash or whatever you have, there should be a remembrance day for the 3.5 million Biafrans that were killed by Nigerian government. Was there any compensation made? No compensation. and you had little problem with Yorubas that led to your people being killed, and you said because of that, you will block every means that we are going to eat tomato. Kai! What an insult. Unakujia yoba. Are you seeing the level of the sea finish? So the tomato and the onions you say you are not going to give us, are you giving it to us free of charge? There is nothing we have not seen because we are one Nigeria. Alalam, I'm asking Aboki, are you giving us onions free of charge? Are you giving us fresh tomato free of charge? That onions you put no mena for. You see that onions? Oh, you put no mena for. You see that fresh tomato? Oh, you have to chew it. You will eat fresh tomato tire. At the end of the day, help me ask the madam around you, who is going to lose? You are blocking every channel that tomato will reach east and west. Who is going to lose at the end of the day? Let me refresh your memory. Who will lose? If you go to Yoruba land, an average Yoruba man, if he's doing his child education, he kills nothing less than three nama. Three cow. If you go to the east, Anigbo, where I come from, Adigbo, once there is any place they are doing burial in Igbo land, apart from the people that are doing the burial, all the people that will come, both the in-laws and the people coming for visit, a particular burial in Igbo land receive more than 50 nama cow meats. I want you to punch that. How much are they selling cow wherever you are now? Calculate it times 50, calculate it times 100. This is the money we are giving to Hausa people. You want to be compensated. If not, you are going to block every means tomato will come. When there was a genocide, when 3.5 million Biafrans were killed in 1967 civil war, did we block you people from going to the south to pick our oil? Did we block you from going to suck our oil and accent manner? In the 1991 Kano State riots, when thousands of Igbo people were killed, when thousands of businesses were destroyed by Hausa people, was there a time that we said that Hausa people will never come to the east again to take oil? Was there a time it happened? And your people were killed in Yoruba land. And you said you will not give onions again. Are we buying it free of charge and asking? This is the level of insult that is always making me angry. Anytime I remember that there is a name Nigeria attached to whatever I stand for. I don't understand. Who is going to lose at the end of the day? Yoruba don't joke with nama. Yoruba don't joke with cow meat. Yoruba love pomo very well. Yoruba is doing party today. They will buy more than one trailer load of tomatoes and fresh pepper, onions included. Igbo people is doing party. Igbo will buy one trailer load of nama. Do unkwobi. Do pepper soup. What do you eat as Hausa man? Hausa, what do you eat? What you eat is gbolo. What you eat is tuwo masala de mi and kuka. What you eat is awara. What you eat is shy. Once you eat goro and your teeth is red, you are comfortable. Once what you drink is all those double yellow leaves, you don't eat any good food. You only eat sugar. You only eat sugar cane. We are the ones consuming whatever you are producing in the north. And you are threatening us. Telling us that you are not going to give us food. What an insult. This is an eye-opener. Yorubas and the Igbos, this is an eye-opener. Hausa don't have water to plant. I want you people to understand this today. Hausa uses irrigation for their planting. We are the people that have that natural resources. You see, when you come to Igbo land and you drop a corn, just drop one corn, the next day the corn will pull no me. But in Hausa land, you will pour water upon water. So if they are surviving, if they are succeeding as farmers, why can't we succeed as farmers in our own place? So far, they said they are developing more than 1 billion naira. Even though I've not started losing, this is just a preamble of what is yet to come. This is a preamble. Igbo people, Yoruba, it's no more that you eat stew with fresh tomato. We have apple, palm kernel, aye, siofaku, almost siofaku, package on a fridge. Ebony State is producing rice. Ohaji is giving us garri. All thanks to Edo State, they are giving us yam and a very nice garri too. We mustn't eat your fresh tomato, that is what I'm saying. And apart from the fact that we almost not be farmers, but at least it is good for us to invest into farming and agricultural business because it's a lucrative one. Because I can wear this my clothes for one good year, be washing it every day, but I cannot stay without food. That hotel that you are always building, once you have and you build a hotel, that is the first thing that comes to your mind. You can still take that money and do agricultural business. It only requires patience. Even these so-called cows that we are begging them to have, to build the ranches, start ranching your cows. You as an Igbo man or Yoruba person, can buy thousands of cows and do it as a business and be making money. People are eating meat every day. People are consuming meat every day. Obasanjo have poultry farm. Obasanjo is a very big farmer. He's a big man. He's a rich person or whatever he is. Well, he has a poultry farm. So why can't you, as a big man in Igbo land or Yoruba land, also have poultry farm and employ all these youths that are jobless? Everybody must not do white collar job. When you invest in agricultural business, hunger will go from our land. Do you know why food items are still very expensive? Because before we eat fresh tomato and onions and fresh pepper, we have to go to Kafancha. We have to call Mala to give us fresh tomatoes. By the time Aboki or Mala calculates his risk, calculates his transportation with the hike in fuel, calculates all the stress that he has taken, 500 naira tomato will turn to 10,000 naira basket. Are you hearing me? That is why we have to come back home. This is an eye-opener. We have to start thinking. When me as Mama Neka is a big farmer and producing onions, Mama Nkechi down the street is a farmer and she's producing fresh tomatoes. The other madam is doing watermelon, cucumber. We have big farmers around. If I want to eat fresh tomatoes, I will go and buy from Mama Nkechi. I don't need to go to maybe transportation, going from one express road to another. And it will be very cheap. Not these outrageous amounts that we're using to buy ordinary fresh tomato and pepper and onions. These people that are starving us of this, are claiming that they are starving us of onions and fresh tomatoes, they cannot consume it. They will be at loss. Hausa will lose. Heavy losing, I'm telling you. Because Hausa is drinking fried onion every day. Hausa cannot cook stew. They cannot sit down and say they are cooking the so-called yam doya that they are doing. They don't eat all those things. What they eat is sugar cane and Lipton tea. We are the ones eating. We eat healthy food. The food that they are doing, guy, that they want to give us, is it not the same carrots that they are using dirty water to wash? The same cucumber they are using dirty gutter water to wash? I'm even scared that if they bring it to us, they might likely poison it. Yes! If you can have that kind of evil mind, to say you will never bring onions in the east and in the west, you can do poison. Yes, that is the level you can get to. So the countries you're taking it to, Cameroon and Ben, I hope they are buying from you. I hope they are patronizing you. Please, Igbo people, we must go back to our roots. We must go and start farming business. This hotel, everywhere you go, you see hotel. Because all one only living in a pure. All one living in a hotel in Jano. Yes. We must look deep because food, anybody that is selling food is doing a lucrative business. But I'm sorry to tell you this. Anybody that is selling clothes and whatever, cow, it might not likely not be a lucrative business. Because that business that will make somebody to something you cannot do without, it is called priority and necessity. That person must eat. You must feed. That is why we have to take farming business seriously. Even if you cannot produce big, large farm that people will be eating, at least you should have a small farm where you're going to plant vegetable or whatever that you can easily go to your farm and take. Yes! So we must take farming business seriously to avoid sea finish. Our graduates, you must not do white collar job. Go and start farming business. Outside people are losing billions. Imagine you are a big farmer and you have fresh tomatoes. Now they have blocked everywhere. They said tomato will not enter. You could have been cashing out real time. It is better we produce what we are eating. We have to start planting what we are eating. It will take time. Sacrifices. We will go hungry. I bought watermelon for 1,500. Watermelon that is like orange. After that, I love watermelon. I said I'm not going to eat watermelon again. Anytime I feel like eating watermelon, I will drink water. And I will stay happy than buying watermelon from you because you feel you are doing me bad. Buying watermelon at an outrageous price from you because you feel you without you, I am not going to feed. Liars from the pit of hell. That is the biggest of the insult we've received so far. Please, we have to take agricultural business serious. You see, livestock business, you see food business, tomato, onions, it is a lucrative business. You must take it seriously. You must take it seriously to avoid sea finish.